and I got one half of a very persistent partnership with me. And no, this lady is
not.
Called Sharon. And Sharon was absolutely determined. Now, what were you determined to do?
Get to meet them.
Get to meet who?
KajaGooGoo.
KajaGooGoo. And how long is this letter that you wrote?
It's about 60 foot.
Have you ever seen anything like it in your life, lads?
No. Hmm?
The other half of the partnership is down there with Mike at the end of the letter.
Yes, this is Joanne down here at the far end of the letter, down the chute down here. How long did it take you to actually write this?
About 3 weeks.
3 weeks, that's amazing, isn't it?
Unbelievable.
Have you ever had a letter this long before?
How many gallons of ink did you use?
That is wonderful. That is wonderful. 3 weeks to write. Were you ever stuck for words?
No, not really.
And what do you think now you've met them?
Fantastic.
Right, but it's gonna be even better in a second because you can stand with Arch and watch as they do Big Apple, all right? This is KajaGooGoo. You come with me. The lads will take the...
Teaming with loot, the sidewalks are scattered. Walking
Fantastic, fantastic. You're gonna come and you're gonna come sit down and have a rest. That was great. Well, what do you think of that?
Great.
Is that good? Terrific. Do you like any single?
Yeah.
Have you bought it yet?
Yeah.
Wonderful, wonderful. Where's your compatriot, Sharon?
Hi, Sharon.
That's Sharon.
Sharon.
That's Sharon. This is Joanne. Are there any burning questions you want to ask them before we let everyone else loose on them on the phones later, which incidentally is 01811 8055 if you want to talk to the lads a bit later. Any a burning question each that you've had?
How long does it take to do your hair?
12 hours. How long does it take to do yours?
Nick never actually gets any sleep, you see. Like, so it's 12 hours to do. It's quite amazing. I'm sure there are more and more of those in there each time.
Yeah, there is, actually.
What about you, Joanne? Have you got a question in there somewhere?
Why did you choose Lemmy as the name for your mascot?
There's a guy in Motorhead called Lemmy, and where we were rehearsing, he was in the next studio, and it seemed to look like Lemmy a bit.
Profound effect on Steve.
Tell you.
Great. Superb. And here's Sarah. Yes, do.
I'm watching, trying to work out where I'm going to sit. So
oh, we'll move up.
Come and sit
we'll
down
move
here.
Can I come
we'll
and sit
up.
Down here? Yeah. Right, then, because I've got a bit of very exciting news. Now, you've seen from this happy story that persistence really does pay off. Now, if you have ever wanted to interview your favourite pop group rock band, now is your chance, because Superstore is running a competition together with the very popular Smash Hits magazine, right? Yep. Now, what you're going to do is, on a postcard... That's a postcard. That'll do, won't it? Now look, you've got to have three things we want from you. First of all, we want to know what questions you would ask the band, your favourite band, okay? Then we want to know what your phone number and name and address is. Fine. Where do we put that? Down.
That bit. Where it says address and phone number.
Down here.
Or you can put it anywhere. But the questions, actually, the more interesting the questions, the more unusual, the better, rather than, you know, the very obvious ones. So the more unusual they are, the better.
And what's the other thing they've got to know? They want to know which pop star, that's right, what questions, and your address and phone number,
and
right?
A stamp, of course.
And, oh, yes,
otherwise
a stamp, because we're a bit mean, right? And then send it off to the usual address, Saturday Superstore, BBC TV, London, W12, 8QT. And the thing is, we want to have those entries as soon as possible. Could be... Anybody, your favourite band? Maybe Bucks Fizz, Madness?
Even you.
Span. Not yet, Michael. Not yet. Okay, so as soon as possible, Smash Hits.
That'll never
and
get in the postbox.
And I tell you what, there are all sorts of prizes to go with this competition, but the interview will probably be published in here.
In the paper?
Yeah.
Wow.
Right.
Oh, that's great, because I always get it, so I can read it. Terrific.
Could be John Craven.
It could. Where is John? I haven't seen him around for ages.
Where is he?
I actually got a feeling, because he's been around for about 15 minutes, that he's left the premises.
He's escaped.
That's right. Well, I'm off the premises, but I haven't gone very...
Yeah, I'm sure that's going to be inundated with calls. Now, look, we've got a bit of a mystery on our hands. Jason and all his pals from Dorking have got me and Jez to come and sit over here, and I don't really know what's going to happen. Could you put us in the picture?
Yeah, well, we're going to levitate. Mm-hmm.
Where's that going to happen?
It's going to just happen there.
There, not up there.
No.
Well,
no.
Good. No. I was a bit nervous about it. Look, who's going to go first? Who's going to go first? He's a coward. Do you want me to go first?
Yeah.
All right, then. Okay. If it works for me, it might work for you. Mind you, you're probably a bit
fast.
Heavier than me.
I can run fast.
Now, what do I do?
Well, we just, four of us push down on your head.
Well, I don't want to know those sort of details. I'll leave that all in your hands, OK? Where do you want me to sit?
Well, in the middle there.
What, on the chair or on the floor or what?
On the chair, please.
What am I doing?
Yeah, what have I let myself in for? Right, on here. Right?
I don't know, yeah.
No, I stay conscious for all this, don't I?
Yeah,
I stay
conscious. Oh,
yeah. Otherwise, I might say things that I'll regret later. Okay?
Good.
Right. Yeah. Oh, no. Right, come on. Don't hurt. Oh, watch my head.
You're going to break your neck now, right?
Oh,
two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight. Superstore! Lift.
And you each did that with two. Just. Yeah. Were you going to be like this?
Yeah, just like that.
That is extraordinary. You've been eating those bananas, haven't you? That's been you stopped all those bananas. I'm going to check later. Let's see if it really works. You try it now, Jez. It's a very weird feeling.
Okay.
This is really weird.
This is really
I'm over 12 stone, so.
Okay.
Oh, gosh.
One, two,
maybe you can
three,
be
four. Five, six, seven, eight, Superstore! Lift.
Can't get in.
Lift.
Oh, that was bad! That was better yourself suddenly lighter?
Yeah.
I've experienced that, you know, when you can push your arm against a wall for a long time, and then when you move away, your sort of arm flexes
backwards the other way.
It's that kind of feeling, isn't it? Well, you might have other tricks and sort of mysteries like that. If you do, write in and tell us all about it. Now, I'm going to go over and put my customer service hat on now, so I'll see you all in a minute, all right? Over to my desk, over here.
And we have a member of Catch a Poo Poo here.
That's
wonderful.
You.
That was great, Tracy. That was super. Right, we're actually going into the pop panel now. Nick Beggs from KajaGooGoo is going to be adjudicating. You can say anything you'd like.
I've got something written on my arm here, look.
The
answers? I have to say, many happy returns to Dorothy Todd, who is the mother of our sax player, who is 62 today. Where's the camera?
Aww.
Well done,
Dorothy.
And also, I hope that Mandy Simpson soon recovers. Hello, Mandy.
Recover soon, Mandy.
From what?
Also on the pop panel, Tracy Ullman, you'll be having a look at them. You ready to adjudicate a little?
Yes, yes.
And also Mac, who you saw earlier, talking about microcomputers with John. I don't know, how well up are you on the world of pop, Mac?
I feel very confident now the Everly brothers are back. I think that's brilliant.
I went to see
Can't be all bad, can it?
I went
I've
to
got
see
something written on my arm, by the way, but it's an invisible ink and I can't get it to come.
Also, I was covered in hair, so you never see it anyway. I went to see the Everly brothers last week and they were fantastic. Despite what you might have read in the newspaper, they were fantastic. Okay, well, I've got this for a... Oh, crikey, that's loud, isn't it? I wasn't expecting that. Or a... Which is much more sedate if you like it. The first one is the new single from Freeze. This is Pop Goes My Love. I think it is anyway. Yes, it is, definitely. But that's... that's Freeze and Pop Goes My Love. Well, Nick, we were actually saying that video is maybe a little on the dark side.
Yeah, the quality, the brightness didn't seem to come through, and also there didn't seem to be a lot of ideas behind it.
Mm. It's very difficult maybe to put new ideas because there's so many videos becoming a very new thing and most groups do videos now. It's very difficult trying to think of something new to do.
I think it is very difficult, but that also is true of making records. You know?
Mm. What do you think about the video and the song?
I think the song's good. I don't like the video.
You don't? No. Okay, that's the follow-up to Freeze's IOU, of course, which is a top three hit, Trace. Did you like that one or not?
Yes, I did. Yes, I like this one too, but same as you, I don't like the video very much. It's not filmed terribly well. Mm. It's not in a very interesting locations, you know. It looks like all the redundant workforce places, you know, they've just gone in where no one's working anymore. Yeah, I like the record, but I didn't really like the video. I know there aren't many ideas left. It's very difficult, and I'm really sick of seeing guys go, look into the camera, you know, that same thing. They go, watch them, I watch them, you know, they always look at the camera, it's trying to be mad. But I like the records, yeah.
Right, Mac, are you a great video watcher or not?
I like listening to the music. That record was great, but nice and sparkly and lively, but the video was gloomy. It was just sort of depressing and gloomy, and it was a complete contrast to the music. I thought it was naff.
Do you think music should generally be happy?
Oh, not necessarily, no, but the music in that record was very happy and lively and it's great rhythm and so on, but the video is...
Because they must be using computers in more and more videos these days to...
Yeah, they are, but they tend to be, unless you spend millions of pounds on it, tend to be fairly poor. It's getting better and it's getting cheaper. You know, some of the big ones like Tron and so on was almost entirely made by a computer. But it's some time before they're going to start making anything to back up a pop record, but they'll do it.
Okay, that was Freeze, and on we go with Depeche Mode and Love in Itself. This is their new one. See what you think of this after we've seen the video. It's Depeche Mode and the follow-up to Everything Counts. That's Love in Itself. Nick was saying, well, that was on, that they are making really good records again. Everything Counts, I thought, was brilliant.
I really liked it. I thought they did some really brilliant stuff at the beginning of their career, and then it went a bit lapsed. Now it's got really good again.
Mm. You ever seen the band or not?
I saw them when they did the gig before they released New Life, and they were superb. Mm.
Great. Okay. I forgot to vote the last one, by the way. It was a for the song and a for the video. Right, that video was... either in Cheddar Gorge or Chislehurst Caves.
I know, I couldn't work out which one it was. I think it's Cheddar Gorge with all the stalactites and stalagmites and things.
Come on, which is which, quickly.
I don't know, stalactites go down. Remember, like, you're pulling your tights down, isn't it right?
I never wear tights.
Stalagmites. Oh, mites, don't I?
Yes,
don't
yes, right, yes.
It's
right.
A great record.
Tights come down, mites go up, don't they?
That's right, yes. I think so.
Yeah.
I really like that because I usually can't. Well, I don't really like them usually. I don't like this synthesizer stuff, but I think that's a great record.
So they've won you over?
Yes, definitely.
Okay, Mac synthesizers in there. Your computer things bring you into the world of synthesizers.
No, but my potholing did. I used to do a lot of potholing, and I can tell you, down potholes, you don't find many people like that floating around, it's usually dank and evil, and you don't get any music down there, and it's horrid and muddy and desperate and depressing and so on. But I thought it was lots of fun. It's a brilliant idea. I wonder if it'll catch on. There's some really deep potholes. You get right down there in the dark, and you can actually film without lights, and nobody'd see anything.
I must ask you, if it's dank, depressing and miserable, why do you go down?
I don't anymore. I didn't discover that. I was a bit thick when I was a lad.
So you get claustrophobia, Max?
It's horrid, especially when you get in those narrow passages and you're scribbling along on the bottom.
Oh, your body gets stuck.
So, for the potholing, because it's depressing and miserable, what the record, because it's wonderful. And here comes the third one. This is Space Monkeys, delightful title, and it's a great record. This one is called Can't Stop. Space Monkeys and Can't Stop. So,
I'm the king of the swingers, the jungle VIP.
Space Monkeys.
I didn't like as much as the Depeche Mode video, but I like the idea of the sort of like warriors chasing him down through London. It was a nice idea.
Good. At least we haven't made you dress up as Dougal from Magic Roundabout this time.
Yeah, thank you very much.
Remember that last time on the screen? We still got a picture of that. We did two Dougals with little black ping pong balls in our noses. Sorry, you won't have to do that. What do you think of the record?
Well, I've heard it a little bit now. Not really over enthusiastic about the record. And the guy's good in the video. He doesn't look at the camera. It doesn't do that. But he's got a bit much makeup on, I think.
Too much makeup.
Yeah, I think it's like half an inch of pan stick on. I like the video. Yeah, I think it's good.
Good job he's not a surprise guest today. Otherwise,
I know, isn't that embarrassing to do that? Sorry.
Mac, was that your cup of tea? Or?
Yeah, the video was exciting. Lots of life, lots of excitement. You didn't know what was going to happen. Anything could happen in it.
Yeah.
You know, I like the video. Yeah, it was lots of punch in it. Good music. I just thought it was okay.
Great. You've been a very good panelist. You can come back again, Mac.
Oh, that's wonderful.
That's like everything, don't you?
Ah, nay, you what?
That's one of those. That's the best bit of the whole show, isn't it? That's great. Right, and we have a bargain to give away. Not only singles from everybody here, KajaGooGoo single, Trace's single, and of course Mac's new 10-inch LP
with nothing on it.
I think you're
silence.
You're no longer
Max, isn't it?
That's right. And the question is for those bargains and the top 10 singles: what does Dolce Vita mean, as in Ryan Paris' current hit? What does Dolce Vita mean? Mean cheese. It means cheese
at
all. Dolce Latte.
What does Dolce Vita mean? Saturday Superstore, BBC Television London. Tahiti. I don't understand half the words, but that's great. Nice to see David Essex down there in the rain. Wonderful. We're here in the warm. See, some days it's better in here. Right, it's time to get on the telephones. We're munching our way through a whole crate of big apples here. Some nice British apples we've got. So if you feel like munching your way through, do. On the line, I don't know who's on here first. Hello. I think we should have somebody on here, but...
Hello?
Hello, is that Michelle?
Yes.
Michelle Quirk?
Yes.
Hi, Michelle. Right, KajaGooGoo got a telephone each and you can talk to who you like.
I talk to any one of them.
Any one of them? We'll talk to all of them. Right, what's your question?
I'd like to ask them whether their parents had any ideas for the jobs that they would have liked them to have when they were little.
Maybe we could go around one at a time. So what would your parents like you to have been? Stuart, what would yours like you to have been?
She would have liked me to have been a teacher, actually, or an orchestral player.
Yeah?
Yeah.
Teacher?
But I said, no, I want to be in a pop band. I think my mum wanted me to be a graphic artist, but I ended up being a dustman.
Yeah, my mum wanted me to be a brain surgeon, but it didn't quite happen. I became a guitarist.
Well, you'd have to work on your own brain to start off with, I think.
I don't know.
My parents didn't want... I think my parents just wanted me to do what I like doing, and I think they're very proud of me doing what I'm doing now.
I'm proud of you,
Jess. Oh,
so
yes,
am
thank
I.
You.
So am I.
What do you want to be, Michelle?
I want to be an actress.
An actress?
So does Nick.
Yeah.
Well, listen, good luck in your ambition. Do you want to say goodbye to the guys?
OK, before I go, what did your parents think of you coming into a pop group? Did they like the idea?
Yeah.
Mine didn't at first.
No, mine at first.
I think mine a lot of people were cynical, you know, to begin with, but you have to prove yourself, don't you, on most things.
But we will get proper jobs soon.
Actually, the parents sort of liked it least. Where did you used to practice? Whose house did you mainly practice in?
Jesse's.
What did your parents think of it? That's the burning question.
Well, I think we eventually got out into the garage, actually, to get out of their hair, you know, but...
You mean they got you out into the garage?
Well, you could put it that way.
Great. Michelle, thanks for your questions.
Thank you.
OK, bye-bye.
Bye.
Bye.
Hi, Michelle.
Right, and I don't know who's next, but hello. Is that Giorgio?
Hello?
Giorgio Bernardi.
Yes, it's me.
Is that you?
Yes.
Oh, great, it's me here. And KajaGooGoo, and you're through to them.
Yes, can I speak to Jez, please?
You have. I'll just munch in my apple, won't it? Yeah, I'm ready.
Hello?
Go ahead.
Can I ask you about Limahl? How did you decide that he wasn't to be in the group anymore?
Well, I think it was just a net natural progression that he decided to go into the pop field, you know, as a solo artist.
Yeah.
And we just wanted to move on a bit musically, you know. So I think he'll do very well, and we're doing well, you know, and we're all happy about it.
I think one thing is you can never believe everything you read in a paper, because you read
many
conflicting reports in newspapers that the only way you actually find out the truth is by asking the people themselves, really.
Yeah.
Okay.
Okay, thank you.
Okay.
Thank you.
Bye. Okay, bye-bye. Right, we have somebody else on the line. It's Wendy Alexander.
Hello.
Hello, where are you calling from, Wendy?
Cheshire.
From Cheshire. Right, you're through to the lads.
I'd like to ask you what advice you'd give to a new group starting up, because I'm in a pop band called Prestige.
Oh, what,
Prestige?
An all-girl band.
Great.
What are they called?
Prestige.
Yeah.
Demo tapes on the way.
We're looking for a new support band.
What advice would you give?
Well,
especially to an all-girl group.
Yeah. All-girl group. Well, for an all-girl group, it would be probably a lot harder than for an all-male group. Yeah, I would have thought so.
It depends. You've just got to have the basic determination in the first place. It doesn't matter who you are.
No, what I mean is that people be very cynical towards it, you know what I mean? Like they were to us.
Well, it depends how pretty they are.
Like girls. Well, basically, you've got to practice hard, obviously. And you've got to have a certain amount of originality. You've got to look for a certain amount of originality, because that's what's needed nowadays. In your music and everything, really, your whole presentation.
What sort of music do you play?
All your own stuff.
Well, that's good. That's a start. It's all girls, is it, the group?
Yeah.
Great.
Good luck.
Good luck from the lads to Prestige.
Keep plugging. That's the best thing.
Okay.
Okay, thanks.
Thanks for your call.
Bye.
Okay, bye-bye. Bye. Time for a couple more in a moment. We better speedily get through your bargains.
Oh.
Jez, what do you have, first of all?
I shouldn't have taken that bite of apple.
All right. We'll give you the question in a moment, and you could win all these things you're just about to see.
I have here a photograph that was taken when we were doing the video in New York.
Mm-hmm.
It was taken with my camera, as I thrust it into my manager's hand, and he took a shot. It's of all the bands, and it's signed there. And that's what I've given away.
Correct.
Yeah, framed by my own fair hands this morning.
Oh, wonderful. Wonderful. Steve, you've got something. Is it down
here?
Yeah,
it's this thing here.
What is it?
It's this shirt.
Not the cassette.
That's yours.
This is the shirt that I wore on the White Feathers album cover on the picture. And there's only one like this about, so...
And it has been washed?
What? Oh, I don't know.
Several times.
Smell the armpits. Anybody with black and white
That's
TV,
part of the bargain as well. Nick, you've got...
Yep.
Oh, I brought this. I did this when I was at college. It's a little drawing of a model we used to have.
That's good.
And that was when I was at college. Yeah, that's Stuart.
That's
one of my more...
You actually did that yourself?
It's dated. It's got that pencil, so I guess I could have scribbled that in anyway, but that's authentic.
It says Day Pose.
Day Pose.
7th of March, 1980, N. Beggs. That could be yours as well in the bargain. That's quite a rarity. We're, of course, going to bung in a KajaGooGoo single, a KajaGooGoo album. And, Stuart, you've got something as well?
Yeah, just a picture of myself.
Oh, you're so modest. You haven't even signed it. Look, here's my pen.
Yeah, like, and also, I've got a tape of first band that I was in called Lazy. And, in fact, this features our manager singing.
And you on bass?
The tracks, and I'm playing the bass guitar.
Wonderful.
So that could be a collector's item.
So, very unusual bargains, then. You've got a framed picture, your shirt, that rare thing, and also the picture as well. Terrific, wonderful. And the KajaGooGoo album and the single, of course. I think you've got time for a couple more calls, hopefully, before we whiz back and say our goodbyes to Keith. And hello, I heard a no. No, who's that?
Sorry.
Hello, who is it?
Karen.
Karen, what's your other name? Karen Shingleton.
Shingleton.
Where are you from, Karen?
Boston.
Okay, fairly briefly, because time's pressing upon us, you're through to the guys.
If you can meet anyone, dead or alive, who do you meet?
Okay, let's go around quickly. Who would you like to meet, Stuart? Dead or alive?
It's Malcolm Arnold.
It's Malcolm Arnold?
Yes.
Right.
Joni Mitchell, I think.
Joni Mitchell, all right.
Stan Laurel.
Stan Laurel.
I quite like David Niven as an
David
actor.
Niven?
It's a shame that he passed away a little while back. So.
Great. Does that answer your question?
Yes.
Okay, the guys say goodbye to you.
Bye.
Bye.
Oh, Mike, right, we forgot to. We forgot to ask the question
for the bargain. The question being, which king introduced Pippin apples to England? Which king introduced Pippin apples to England? These type of English Pippin apples, okay? Which king introduced these to England? Write to us, Saturday Superstore, BBC Television, London, W12, HQT. You can win all the KajaGooGoo bargains. I think we may have time, very busy programme, this, for one more call. Have we got time for one more call? I think no more calls, haven't we time? Right, we're going to say a goodbye to Sarah and David. How are you?
Fine,
you've enjoyed
thank
you
very
it so
much.
Far?
Yes, enjoying it very much. What about the telegram service? Don't forget to send in some telegrams too, please. Thanks very much.
Okay. And John?
Hello.
It's been a great first one. The same exciting pullovers actually.
Where's my banana? My banana. I want to be a banana.
Do you want an apple?
Come on, banana.
While they're exchanging fruit, we'll nip back and see what the other old fruit's doing down by the river. Keith.
Yeah, that's all from us, folks. We had a smashing time down here. Johnny Ball, have you enjoyed it?
What? Enjoyed what? Lovely.
Thanks very much to John and Pat, Stevie J and Mr. Essex for coming up with us this morning.
Oh, it's a great pleasure. Thank you.
Good luck with the single, by the way. Have you enjoyed it? Good news. That's all from us
and
Eaton till next week. See you, Mike.
Great. OK, Keith, it's very exciting down there, isn't it? But it is pouring with rain. I reckon we're better off here. John, are you going to change if you eat that?
You can see.
A banana man could change into you.
It's Craven Man.
On the store. You see what bananas do to you, don't touch them. On the store next week, Leo Sayer will be coming. We'll be doing a bit of live business with Leo. And, of course, he'll be singing his new single. Wham! A lot. No, actually, not at the moment. I'll have one in a minute. Also, Wham! George and Andrew will be in as well. We have Liftoff and Mike Finley, our resident vet. And also before us next week at 25 to 9, One Inch High Private Eye. So there's a cartoon on at 25 to 9 just before us. We're on at 9 o'clock through until 12:15. Thanks to KajaGooGoo for coming in.
Thank you.
Good luck with Big Apple, but you won't need it because it's a great single. Thanks to all our guests for coming in this morning. We'll see you 9 o'clock next week. It's time to say goodbye from us. Goodbye from John and Sarah and Banana Man and KajaGooGoo. See you next week. Okay,
bye.
Bye.